Fridays mean unplugged on 702.
It is about that time when we get to kick back and relax and enjoy some music. But before we do that, we get to chat to our performer for today, Bongi Archi, who is actually born Bongi Mtombeni. And you may have seen him as one of the popular members of Idols. He was in the top 8 back in 2010, but he is a recording artist and a singer-songwriter. He joins us today. Bongi, welcome to the show. How are you doing?
Hey, I'm good. How are you? I'm super, super excited to be here. Hello to all the listeners and everybody. Finally, I get to be on 702 with you.
You made it.
Oh my
goodness. Tell us about your exciting new project. What can people expect from you and your sound?
Look, it's I'm going for the world sound. I'm going for everybody can sing along and dance along to sound. I'm going for the I feel your pain sound. I'm gonna get you through it. I'm going for the you in love, let me help you, know, give you some tips on how to love her or him. So it's a very brand new sound and a very brand new exciting journey where I'm now doing only my originals, where all the other years I've been doing covers.
And I mean, the great thing about your original music is you get to interpret it your own way without having to follow in the footsteps of another artist. But your own songs are actually songs you have written. So what is your songwriting journey and process?
Mine is very much spur of the moment. So everything I go through, everything that happens in my life, every experience, that I see, I then sit down and I then start with the heading of, you know, like I'm sitting out here and it's so beautiful. I mean, I've got a show today, but I was like, hey, you know, it's good to get here early so I can write anything about, you know, the calmness and the beauty of nature, the green peace, you know. Then I just write a heading and then I just go back and I just do the I'll write the chorus before I write the verses, because verses are very tricky and you want people to relate to them. So that journey, that process has been going for years, but now it's time to put it onto record and let people hear it.
So in terms of a lot of the subject matters that you cover, we know many songs are about love. What are your songs about?
Well, as an artist, you have to cover some of those. You got to cover love. You got to cover peace. You got to cover, you got to motivate. You got to get people happy. You got to get them dancing. And, you know, so my writing covers nearly all of them, you know, heartbreak, sadness, and uplifting music. So I write all of that. I mean, I write everything from pop to reggae all the way through to gospel.
And what was the main messaging that you want to leave people with your music?
You know, I've come to realize that music is one thing that everyone can relate to. When you said you put on a CD, or put on the iTunes, or put on music on your iPad or wherever on your phone, and you listen to music, you listen to the genre of music that could help you go through those emotions. So my music is everything that is real. My music is real. And I want to leave people, when you sad, I want you to put my song, listen to my song and be happy. When you're happy, I want you to put my song on and be super happy. When you feel you need spiritual upliftment, I want you to select one of my songs or albums coming soon and then be uplifted. So it's music that heals the soul. Let me put it like that. Heals the soul, because you got to be happy. You got to stay positive. You got to lift yourself up and be motivated and know that, you know, today's not the end of the day, the end of the world. Tomorrow we carry on and lift ourselves up and yeah, we strive again.
Why did you choose to change your name? What was that all about?
So this has been after big blessing that I got after having to travel nearly the whole world, and I was kind of figuring, Guti, it was difficult for people to pronounce Mtombe, and it was kind of like hard. They were like, yo, we can't pronounce Mtombe. Is it Mtombeni? And I was like, even
listen,
the Chinese.
My name is Relebogile. I understand. No one. Very few people are able to just pronounce it the first time, so I get it.
Exactly. So then it came to my sister actually went and did a research about my second name, Archibald, and she gave me this thing, Bongi, do you know how strong your name is, your second name? It means a lot, you know. It's a bold and it's a strong name, and I think you shouldn't hide it. You should let people know. But then after sitting out with my productive team and my marketing team and everyone, we sat down and I was like, guys, what do you think of Bongi Archi? Because why I kept the name Bongi, because it's a short name of Bongi Nkosi, it's because I still want to keep my Africanism. Yeah, I still want to be known Kuthi Ubongi. It's not Mark Archie or Frank Archie or David Archie. It's Bongi Archi. So they know actually Lombanalo, he's African, but then he's also accommodating the whole world. So I put that together, keep my roots, keep my Africanism, but still take the music and myself to the world. So that's why the name changed.
I see. Bongi Archi, his music is coming up.
Hello, guys. It's Bongi Archi here, and I'm super excited to be hanging with the Relebogile Mabotja here on 702. As long as hanging with you, 702 listeners, it's a super, super beautiful day and a super exciting moment for us to be chilling. And, you know, I'm so excited and grateful for you all to listen to my unplugged session here on 702. We're going to kick it off with a very beautiful and easy song called A Sweet Child of Mine. I hope you guys enjoy it.
She's got a smile, but it seems to me reminds me of childhood memory, where everything was as fresh as the bright sky. Now and then when I see her face, she takes me away to that special place. And if I stare too long, I'd probably break down and cry. Child of mine, oh, sweet love of mine. She's got eyes of the bluest sky, as if they were made of rain. I hate to look into those eyes and see an ounce of pain. Her reminds me of a warm, safe place where as a child I'd hide. Oh, and pray for the thunder and the rain to quietly pass me by. Yeah. Oh, sweet child of mine. Thank you.
All right, now next up, I thought maybe let me just, you know, throw in my original single, which is out there on all digital platforms. It's called Excuse Me. So if you haven't downloaded it yet, I hope you are on your way to your digital platforms to download it. I'm going to sing it unplugged today just for you. You know, it's kind of like exclusive. I've never done this before. So, hey, just because you're a 702 listener, I guess this is your lucky and special day. Enjoy. Have you seen the smile on her face? Have you seen her grin? Have you seen her skin? Everything she said is hard not to erase. Yeah. I just wanna walk to her and ask her if we could. So excuse me, may we be friends? For this moment, I don't want it to end. 'Cause deep inside, I know I've fallen in love. Yeah. So excuse me, may I be your friend? Have you heard her laugh? Have you heard her sing? All day in my head, all I hear is wedding bells ring. She's always happy, you can see it in her eyes. I just wanna walk to her and ask her if we can. So excuse me, may we be friends? For this moment, I don't want it to end. Oh, deep inside, I know I'm falling in love. Yeah. So excuse me, may I be your friend? Oh, all I see in my dreams is you. In my future, you exist too. So I wrote this song for you, hoping somehow it'll get to you. I don't promise to give you the world, but together we can create our own world. Woo, 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 baby. So excuse me, may we be friends? For this moment, I don't want it to end. 'Cause deep inside, I know I'm falling in love. Yeah. So excuse me, may I be your friend? All right, y'all. They say all good things come to an end. So thank you so much for listening and hanging out with me. But I don't leave you alone. I leave you with one of my, you know, favorite songs, Tenderness. And, you know, since we're approaching the month of February, the month of love, you know, just try being a little bit tender. Not only to the one you love, but to everyone in general. And let it not be only in February that you spend or you spread love. Let it be every day of your life. This is Bongi Archi. Thank you so much to all you wonderful and fabulous 702 listeners. Enjoy my last number, Tenderness. And it goes something like this. maybe we real. Them young girls, they do get weary wearing the same old shaggy dress. But when she gets weary, you gotta try a little tenderness. Oh, yes, you do. You know she's waiting, just anticipating the thing that you never, 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 never possess. But while they're waiting, you gotta try a little tenderness. Oh, oh, yes, you do. Oh, it's not just so sentimental. No, 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 no. She's got her griefs and cares. Oh, by the soft words spoken so easy, oh, it makes it easier, oh, easier to bear. You won't regret it. Young girls, they don't forget it. But it's so easy. Oh, you got to just try a little tenderness, baby. Ooh. Just squeeze her, never tease her. Oh, just please her. Oh, you got to just try a little tenderness, baby. Don't leave her. Oh, you just please her. Oh, just try a little tenderness, baby. Just please her. Oh, never tease her. Oh, na 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 na. Ooh, ooh, boo, 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 baby. Just please her. Oh, don't you leave her. You got to, you got to, you got to just try a little tenderness.
Fridays mean unplugged on 702.